Hey, what's going on? This is Dylan with Dylan Talks Tone, and this is actually take three on this video because I tried to do it twice live. Let me explain. We are at Myrtle Beach State Park in South Carolina, and reception sucks here. And so I thought, well, maybe it'll be easier just to do a live stream instead of like record and produce a whole video and put it up. And I've been trying to do a video every day this month, and of course the live stream didn't work twice, and so we're gonna try it this way. Today we're gonna talk about three myths surrounding guitar pots. These are things that we see all the time on forums and on Facebook groups, and there's a lot of marketing surround them, and personally I think a lot of money wasted. So let's get straight into it. Number one, that you have to change your pots. Myth number one is that you have to change your pots just because. Like, a lot of people will buy a inexpensive guitar and they'll be like, well, these cheap pots. Don't look at those tiny little, that's my favorite part. Look at those tiny little Chinese pots. They must be robbing tone. The job of a potentiometer, it has two jobs in a guitar. One is a voltage divider for the volume, and two, it's a variable resistor for the tone. And they, in a normal guitar setup, and all they do is cut voltage on the voltage divider volume, and the other one is a variable resistor allowing some signal to pass through a capacitor to ground. Super simple jobs, really. They are a very simple device, and either they work or they don't. If they get scratchy and dirty, then you want to replace them or try to clean them. If they start to not work very well, if they get loose, if they, you know, you have problems with them, then yeah, a lot of times you're going to want to replace them. Here's the thing though. Oh, okay. So here's another thing. One, another reason is you don't like the taper. Do you remember a couple weeks ago or so, we did a video on our 40,000 subscriber giveaway guitar, that Gretsch Junior Jet, because I wanted to show that the tone didn't really change when we replaced pots from the small, miniature, cheap Chinese pots that everybody calls them to a higher quality Born's pot. The tone didn't change. What did change though is the taper. If you'll recall from that video, we'll link it up here, that when you turn the volume down, it was more like a switch and less like a properly tapered potentiometer. So if you want to change the taper so that your volume or your tone works kind of like you expect it, then you probably would want to change them. But if you're a leave it on 10 guy, which a lot of people are, then you just can leave it. There's no real reason to change it. There's no reason to change it just because. Myth number two. Myth number two is this whole matching pots thing. There are companies that market matched potentiometers. What does that mean? Let's take, for example, a Les Paul. Les Pauls have four, right? Theoretically, under the matched pot situation, what you would do is you would make sure that these two pots would match these two pots, or all four pots would be the same. And basically it would mean that they would be the same value. So let's say on a Les Paul and you wanted 500K pots, you would measure them and they would come to you pre-measured so that they would all be exactly the same. When pots are made, they're made to a tolerance. 10, 15, 20% is typical. The ones we buy are 15%. On a 500K pot, they could be 15% up or 15% below. When I actually pull them out of the bag when I buy them and check them, I don't ever really see a full 15%. Typically, it's only 8 or so, maybe, something like that. 10 or 15K off of normal. It's really, really not that much. Let's say you buy four pots from Amazon, you get them home, and a 500K pot has 520K. This other one has like 490. This other one has like 495. Maybe this other one has like 470. Does it matter where they go? The matched pot guys would argue that they wouldn't use them in the guitar, or they would take the closest ones and put them closer together. This volume with this tone and this volume with this tone, like put the 520 next to the 510 and put the 490 next to the 495, right? Here's the thing though. The pickups in your guitar, your Les Paul, for example, do two different jobs for two different reasons. One, the bridge pickup and the neck pickup are completely different positions. If they were wound exactly the same with the exact same magnet, they would still have different frequency responses, therefore different pots would affect them differently. So there's no real reason for them to be matched. Because the treble pickup, there's a reason they call it the treble pickup, and the rhythm pickup is in a different spot. They produce a completely different frequency response. So does it matter if the volume, this volume is 490K and this volume is 510K? No, it does not. The other thing is that most people don't have matched pickups. Most people don't have the same exact wind with the same exact magnets in both positions. Therefore, the inductance, the overall capacitance, and the DC resistance of said pickups are completely different. So there's really no reason to have pots matched based on that. The other thing is that volume pots and tone pots do completely different jobs. They don't do the same job. This one's a voltage divider, this one's a variable resistor. This one passes some signal through a capacitor to ground, and this one passes all the signal to ground. They do completely different jobs, they're wired completely different ways, and there's really no reason for them to be matched either. Plus, you have that whole position situation, the rhythm pickup versus the treble pickup. So there's really no reason for any of them to be matched. It's a total myth. Now, would you just not care about tolerances? No, I would definitely, when you buy pots, make sure that they are within tolerance. Obviously get what you paid for, but don't like freak out if they're not exactly the same, because most 99.999% of players are not going to be able to tell the difference. And I would venture to say that 100% of people are not going to be able to tell the difference in a blind test if I didn't tell you what I did. It's one of the guitar mods to me that is like, you only can hear a difference if you know it's in there, sort of thing. Myth number three, that you need to get rid of those cheap Chinese pots and put American-made pots in your guitar. There is no such thing as an American-made pot. All the major brands, Alpha, CTS, and Bourne's, are all made overseas. Those three brands do not make pots in the United States. If you see a company claiming to sell American-made pots, they are basically lying to you as a marketing scheme. And the reason they're saying that is because anybody, you, if you wanted to, could call Bourne's or CTS or Alpha, give them some money and say, I'm gonna order 100,000 pots and I'm gonna put Joe Blow's pots on them. And you could say, I want this taper, I want this resistance, and I want to put my name on these pots, and boom, you would have pots. And if you lived in the United States and you had a company in the United States, you could go so far as to claim that you had American pots, but then you would be basically lying to people because you were private labeling pots that were made overseas. Alpha is made in China, CTS is made in Taiwan, and Bourne's are made in China. And it's been that way for a very long time. Does that matter? No. All three companies, guitar pots are like the least of their worries. They all make aerospace, missile guidance systems, stinking, they do all kinds of stuff that is way more complicated than a variable resistor for a guitar. It's like absolute, they are capable of making really, really good stuff. Now, does that mean that the cheap pot that comes in the guitar is gonna have a great taper? No, because they have like levels too, right? So they have like, I bet these little mini pots that go in $300 guitars cost X amount of cents a piece, and the ones that go in Fender Custom Shop guitars cost X amount of cents a piece when Fender buys them. So there are levels to them, but none of them are inherently crap. Like, you just can't go and say, I need to buy American-made pots because America, because you won't get them. There are companies like Emerson, like Gibson, and others who private label them, but they are not made in the United States. What they typically do is they order to their own airplane. We're right next to an airport also. What they typically do is they order to their own tolerances, or they just buy tons of pots in a box. I know amp builders do this. I know amp builders that do this. They buy tons of pots in a box, and then they literally like pay a guy to sit there and like check each one of them and like throw the ones that are outside of their personal tolerances in another box, and they'll throw them on eBay or something, and they'll put these ones in their guitars or their amplifiers or whatever, and then they'll charge more because they had to pay that guy to sit there and check them all. Because he did that in the United States doesn't make them made in the United States. Just FYI. That's the deal. Anyway, there's three myths. Let me know if you have any questions. Thanks for your patience, even though we had to do this three times today. Make sure you go to dylancontest.com and enter to win the 40,000 subscriber giveaway guitar, because we're getting very close. It's going to be in the next couple of weeks. The other thing is Sunday night, this coming Sunday night, May 24th, we are going to be doing a live Zoom class about guitar nuts. This is part two of our guitar setup course that we're doing once a month. The cool part is, if you sign up for this Sunday over at patreon.com/DylanTalksTone, the following Sunday is also in this month, so it's a 5-Sunday month. So we are going to give you a free class if you enroll for this Sunday. We don't know what that one's going to be about. I'm leaving that up to all the patrons who are part of the class. So get over there and do that. And if this upload goes well, and we can continue to do this everyday thing, which I hope, we will see you tomorrow.